Today you will learn about a fairly new approach to reinforce 3D printed parts with carbon fiber. And we are doing this to build the structure of our humanoid style robot arm. Now we will show the process with this simple pipe shaped robot base, which we will precisely mill to the specs. But you can also do this with very organic shapes, like for example this joint linkage right here. And these parts are rock solid, so off to work. First we will hollow out our part. This is where you need to be a little creative with the design. We have a wall thickness of 1 millimeter. To reinforce and also add threads to the part, we use these aluminum rods. Now they are anodized, but this is not ideal. As you might know, carbon fiber is conductive, so they will corrode away eventually. For the prototype, this will be totally fine. We also designed features in the shell itself to locate our inserts and to fill up the shell with carbon fiber even faster. We designed this funnel specifically for this part. We are using 5 to 15 millimeter chopped carbon fiber. We found the distance between the walls ranging from 4 to 5 millimeters enough so that the carbon fiber will still drop inside the shell. This part of the process involves a bit of manual labor. It's totally worth it if you pack the carbon fibers evenly into every cavity of the part. We have two perimeters on this 3D print. With this simple cylinder, it's pretty much watertight, but to just not risk the epoxy draining out, we additionally wrap the part with tape. We then mix the epoxy resin, which has a very low viscosity and is suited for vacuum infusion. We are now using a syringe to pour the epoxy into the funnel and just let it drain by gravity. It will work itself down. So this can take up to 20 minutes, but in our experience the resin will even flow 6 hours after this because it has such a low viscosity. Now we will mill a fixture to clamp this part into the CNC machine to mill it precise. And here we have the finished result with locating pins for the gearboxes and such a solid part, and it turned out so great that we will definitely use this process again for the other linkages. We are building robot parts every day at the moment, and since most of the development is done, never is, we have now more time to show you what we are doing. If you like this kind of content, just leave a comment. I'm always happy to read all of your comments. See you in the next video. Thank you.